Today we're going to talk about switch end stops on the Big Tree Tech SKR version 3. So I need to talk about a couple of things. I've gone over it briefly in the basics tutorial, which you'll find in the actual description for the playlist. But essentially, we have our X minimum, our Y minimum, and our Z minimum. Now we need to know what these pins are that are in here. So we need to know, like for instance on here, the green wire coming off is actually the signal pin. In this case, the black wire is ground and then voltage is down here. Now for the one over here, this is actually going to be black and red. Now the red is actually going to be signal and the black is actually going to be ground. And that's the way this one's wired from the factory. So I'll show you how to hook up both. So let's transition over to the GitHub page for the SKR. And as you can see, Big Tree Tech. Now you can't find the repository right away, and I've covered this already before, but if you click on repository and you say SKR, it'll bring you right to it if I type it correctly. There we go. So here we go. Now, as you can see, there's two folders for hardware. There's going to be an SKR3, and then there's the EZ, which is the new type of stepper that they've come up with. So if you click here, you can see that you have a pinout diagram. So if you click on that, you can see what your pins are. So in this case, we have our XN stop. But if we go over here, we can see it's 5 volts, ground, and then the signal is the individual pin rate here. And that'll be the same for like your Y at end stop over here, which is 5 volts, ground, and then your pin type. So as you've noticed over here, you have your filament run out, and then you also have your power detect. Over here, you can actually use these still as end stops if you so choose, but you have to manipulate the Marlin config file and possibly the pins file for this board, which I've talked about in the previous basics tutorial. So what I'm gonna actually talk about first, if we go back over to the board, we're gonna look at the actual situation we're in. So as you can see right here, we have a red and a black wire. So we know, based on what we just saw, that this is going to be voltage, ground, and then signal. So if we flip this into the direction that it will be in, you can see that the red is actually going to be used for ground and the black is going to be signal. So I'm going to insert that for the X end stop. Now for the other one, we have a green wire, a black wire, and a red wire. So that means that the actual voltage is going to be on top, then it's going to be the ground, and then signal. So we're going to place it right in here for the Y end stop, so you can see that. So we're going to go over to Marlin in a second on the desktop, and we're actually going to load this. Now, I have to warn you that I'm actually using a modified version of the actual Marlin firmware that you can see over here. So if we go back, there's an actual modified version that I've rolled back to the actual firmware defaults that may exist when Marlin comes out, and it probably will be Marlin 2.0.9.4. It's currently not released, so I've checked this daily, almost hourly, and it still hasn't been done. And I've also checked the bug fix, which I normally do not use when I'm working with the board, because this is a development branch and may have issues. So over here, I've actually posted this up on Patreon for the people that are interested, as it took a little bit of work to actually develop. So it's downloadable if you join Patreon, which will be in the description link in the video. It's the actual rolled back version. So I'm going to go over to downloads. Then I have it right here. and I'm going to open this folder. Now, when you have the regular Marlin, this will actually look slightly different. It will be like this. So there'll be two folders that you have to go down. So let's go back over here and open this up. It's the whole folder. As you can see, the Mega 2560 is the default currently. So what we're going to do is we're going to close this real quick. We're going to minimize the pins file for just a second so I can actually see what I'm doing, if I can get this file to actually look normal. Hang on a second. So my normal route to set the configuration.h for our board type would be, I go to the source folder, the core folder, boards.h, and then I'm going to search on the SKR version 3. So let me bring this to the top so you can see there's multiple board types in here. And one of the ways that we can search is by doing Control F and then saying SKR underscore 3. And this will bring us to the category for our processor, which is an ARMS Cortex M7. Now let me show you that actually on the desktop what I'm talking about. In the actual center over here, if I zoom in, that's the processor. So it's STM32H743. So the 7 is where we are. Now, I have to point this out, which is going to be kind of weird, but the processors lately on the SKR boards have been changing. So if a new board comes out, examine your MCU, which is the processor right here, and the writing on it. There may be a new category that it will move to. So let's go back over here for a second. And what we're going to do is we're going to copy the boards underscore BTT underscore SKR underscore 3. We're then going to minimize this and the source, go to configuration.h, and we're going to paste it right here. After it's pasted right here, what we're going to do is we're going to change the serial port to -1 so that we can communicate via serial over here. And I'm going to leave the speed at 250,000 bits per second, or excuse me, the baud rate of 250,000. So once that's done, what we're going to do is we're going to have to change the actual platform I/O to the correct configuration. So inside here, we're going to have to go to the INI file. Then we'll find our board type, which is STM32H7. And inside here, you can see that the board is specified right here. So we're going to copy this environment. We're going to close out of here and go to Platform I/O, highlight the Mega 2560, and paste it over that. Now, that's the normal configuration. Now, there is an issue where your end stops may be inverted. Now, I'd like to show you the error and what occurs and how you can fix it, but it's going to make the tutorial a little bit longer. So I'll show you this initially, and then I'll go back and fix it. So essentially what we're going to be searching for is, I believe, end stops. So this might take a second to actually get to the right place. So end stop settings. You can see that there, currently we have enabled the X minimum, the Y minimum, and the Z minimum. Down here we have pull-ups. This is used to smooth out the actual signal. You generally don't need to use those anymore. And then you have the invert. So in this case we have the X minimum, the Y minimum, and all the other ones. These I suggest avoiding just because this is new functionality that still hasn't been sorted out. So essentially the issue is going to be right here for the Y minimum, and I'll show you after we build and install, we'll go back and fix. So I'm going to click on the checkbox to actually do a build. The yellow is just a warning, and this is due to the actual version that I'm working with currently. This should go away. If you do see red in here though, that means that it's actually a failure, and you might see multiple ones. Always go for the very first one to fix. And the rationale is the other issues are a cascade of errors that occur. Now, I also have a Discord channel where you can enter the general chat, and almost everyone in there knows how to sort out these issues. If not, I'll be around to actually look once in a while. But it's very busy for me in Discord, so just keep that in mind. So as soon as this builds, what's occurring up here is it's actually populating this folder with the actual build. So there's our build right here. So I'm going to right click on this and I'm going to go to Reveal in File Explorer. Now it popped up on the other screen, so I'll bring it over here. And essentially we need the USB SD card. So I'll show you how to do that real quick. So over here, I'm going to have to pop out the actual drive and place it in here. And because we're actually loading this on a USB drive, I'll plug it in over here. We're actually going to use the USB power to troubleshoot it. So they leave off the actual jumper now. So I'm going to have to place this on here so we can power the board. And let me show you this real quick so you understand. If I plug this in without direct power, it will not power the board. If I take this out and I place this here, it will power the board, but it can affect your steppers for TMC type steppers. That's why you always want to leave it off now and use direct power. But we're just running tests on the end stop. So I'm going to plug this in, and as you can see, it'll beep in a second, and that allows us to communicate. So I'm going to unplug this for a second. And we're gonna go back over to the desktop. And what we're gonna do is look at the actual drive. Now this was the firmware load from last night. So it says firmware.cur in all capital letters. That means it loaded successfully. So we're gonna right click and we're gonna send this to the drive. So if we go back over here, now there's two. If it loads successfully, it will be this name. If you want to load it on multiple devices that are the same type or motherboard being SKR3, you would rename it to this so you could load to the other boards. That's only if the configurations are the same. So I'm going to go back over to the workbench. I'm going to pop out the drive. I'm going to plug it in over here for the SD card. And this will keep moving around due to the heat. So this will start to load over here. It'll beep in a second. So the next thing I'm going to have to do is open up what I use. It's called Pronterface. This is a tool that I use in order to troubleshoot what's going on with the board. So let me show you what that looks like. So over here we have Pronterface, and as you can see, we have the COM port already in existence, meaning that it knows what it is. This is due to I opened it after I plugged it in. But to check this, we can do this. We can type device manager. And inside device manager, which I'll bring over here so you can see, the COM port is actually right here. If you were to disconnect your USB, this would go away. This is the actual connection that we're maintaining with the motherboard. So let me close this. We'll click connect. And as you can see, it now says the printer is online. So the next thing we need to do is actually look at this through the camera to test it. But before we do that, I'm going to type M119 and press enter. And what you'll see is they all say triggered. So there may be something going on or not. But let's test that by checking. So if I go over to the configuration over here, and I actually click this with my finger, and then I do this code again, you can see that it says open. So what that means is it's inverted. So let's try the other one real quick here. So I'm going to click this one, and I'm going to do M119. And now it says open. So they're both inverted. So let's go back over and repair this issue. So what I need to do is go over to here. I need to go to configuration.h and we're going to change this to true. We're going to do the same thing over here and change it to true. Then we'll actually rebuild right here. Most of the time I do a clean, which is this little garbage can for platform IO. But in this case, it's just a small change. Hopefully there will not be an issue. And then while that's occurring, I'm actually going to pop out the drive for the SD card to speed this up and place it back in the computer. So you may hear a beep while I'm doing this. And as soon as this completes up in here, which you can see it's almost there, first we'll see a actual similar firmware.bin in here, hopefully. But let's give this a second to build. So we're actually just watching right here. So you can see that it's almost there. There's just one other thing that, it's about to happen. There it is. So we'll right click and we'll say reveal in File Explorer. We'll click on this. We'll double check to see if the last build loaded, which it did, and then we'll send it to that drive. Now we'll go back over to the desktop. We'll pop out the drive. We'll pop it into the actual computer. Now, you normally don't want to do this with the power on, but it's already loaded. That's a bad thing to do. But in my case, I know it's not going to do any damage at this time. But don't do it yourself. Now I'm going to re-plug this in. And it should be loaded. So let's minimize what I have on my desktop so you can see what I'm doing. Give me a second here to bring it up. Now let's reconnect. We're probably going to have to disconnect first, then reconnect. So now we're back online. We'll do the M119. Now you can see they're both open. So let's click the first one with our finger and try this again. So now it says that it's triggered. So I'll undo that and I'll do the same over here. And you can see it now works. So essentially what's occurring, let me do that again with my finger because that's not right. Okay, apparently it's not working for this one. So it could be the nstop type that I'm using, or there could be a loose connection or multiple other things here that are occurring. But we can test this a different way. We're going to disconnect for a second, and this could be a bad nstop. So I'm going to pop this out. Then I'm going to pop this over here to test it. I guess having this error is actually a good thing so you can see what's going on. So that's plugged in now, so it's connected to this one. So let's reconnect and see what happens. So it might take a second to reconnect because I didn't plug in the actual USB. You get a West Comedy of Errors. Now let's reconnect. It's back online. Let's do an M119. Currently it says open. Let's trigger it with our finger and do this again. And now it says triggered. So it looks like the nstop I was using for the second one is not working or effective. It could have to do with the actual wiring of the board, the way they place the tracing and the circuitry on it, or it could be that it's broken. But thank you all for taking the time to watch my video, especially my patrons and the people on PayPal. I will place at the end of the video a thank you note to all the people that have either joined Patreon or have donated on PayPal. Everyone, remember to like and subscribe. And everyone, take care and have a nice day.